guys, today I'm in the forest and the reason I'm here is because someone sent me a letter and I thought I'd share this special adventure with you guys. Let's see what it says. Dear Jackie, that's me, and boys and girls, that's you guys. It said, are you ready for adventure? Are you brave and tough and strong? If you think you are, then why not come along? You'll wander through the forest, but stick to the path. Meeting different creatures, doing different tasks. If you're really brave enough, there's something you should know. Somewhere on the path, you'll find the Gruffalo. How exciting is that? An adventure to maybe find the Gruffalo. So I came here to my favourite park and I decided to have a little look down the path for the Gruffalo. But before I started, I had to learn some forest instructions. So I got my friend and his name is Sydney Squirrel. Everyone say hi. Yeah. And Sydney Squirrel wants to teach us a really fun game that's called the Forest Game. Okay, I think we can play that. So, Sydney's gonna give us the instructions and we've got to copy. Okay, so everyone find a space and stand up tall. Okay, make sure you've got lots of room about you. Good, yeah, I've got lots of room out here in the forest. Okay, right, so here's the instructions. So, if Sydney says, really? If Sydney says tree, you've got to pretend you're climbing up really tall in a tree. So everyone try that, tree, climb up really tall. Perfect. If Sydney says mud, you've got to lie down on the ground on your bellies. Let's try that. Mud and tree. Good. Mud and tree. Excellent. If Sydney says river, we're going to pretend the river's really, 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 really far away. So you've got to run, 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 run. As close to whatever you're watching this on as possible. It could be the TV or your iPad. And if I say pond, you've got to run as far away as you can to the very back of the room. So let's try those instructions. River. Good. Pond. And the other instructions, mud. And tree. Perfect. If Sydney says burrow, now burrow is a little small hole down in the ground where some different animals stay. So if we say burrow, you've got to get into a little small ball on the ground. Everyone try that, burrow. Perfect. And if he said nest, yeah, nests are usually up high in trees. You've got to go up in your tiptoes and make a big circle nest. Perfect. Okay, so let's try those four instructions, ready? So mud on your tummies and tree. Climb up nice and tall. Perfect. And river. Come as close as you can. And pond. Run as far away. And burrow into a little ball. And nest into a big tall. Big tall nest. Brilliant. Okay. And if Sydney says someone's coming, you've got to stay still as a statue. And not move. You can't move at all until I say the coast is clear, and that means you can move around again. The coast is clear. Okay, so let's try all of those instructions, and if you've got someone in the house with you, you can play, get them to play along as well. Okay, I'll put the music on and we'll get started. Okay, ready and mud down your bellies. Good, tree, up as tall as you can. River, whoa. Pond. And walk around. Okay, it says walk around like a squirrel. Mud. Tree. Burrow, small, super small. Someone's coming. Walk around. Remember, the coast is clear. Walk around. Good. And burrow. Blank, mud! Tree! Someone's coming! The coast is clear. Jump around! Okay, swing from the trees, go! Okay, and funnel! Nest! River! Pond! River! Pond! Mud! Tree! Someone's coming! Coast is clear! And stop! Well done, everyone. Give yourselves a big clap. Well done. High five. Okay, that was brilliant. Thank you, Sydney, for teaching us a bit about the forest. But it's time for us to travel down the path. Really? Sydney says, are we looking for the Gruffalo? We might be. Do you think he lives here? He does live here, so we might get to see him. That's really exciting. Everyone say bye to Sydney. Bye! So, here we are at the start of the path, and just as we're about to start walking down it, we hear this. That's a noise that I don't know. Maybe it's the Gruffalo. But it turns out it's not the Gruffalo. It's another one of our forest friends. So here is Freddy Fox. Everyone say hello. Hi, Freddy. Now, Freddy says that before we walk down the path, he has to teach us how to be brave and strong and not scared of anything. He has to teach us how to be just like a fox. Okay, let's give it a go. A fox can walk and leap and run. A fox is sly, but also fun. He'll bare his teeth, then wag his tail, light on his feet, and then a wail. So the fox is telling us that he can walk around the forest, he can run, he can jump, he can be a little bit scary to scare off any bad guys, and he can be lots of fun, and he can bare his teeth, and then he can wag his tail because he's really happy. Okay, I think we need to learn and be a bit like this fox. Okay, so how do we do it? Okay, so first we have to get down on all fours, everyone get down on all fours, and start to walk around the room. Perfect. And then we've got to run, so we've got to do it even faster. So everyone try that. Perfect. And then we've got to try leaping. So everyone try leaping like the fox. Oh, he's coming to see. Oh, he says you're very good at leaping. Okay, keep going. Brilliant. And then you've got to give a big like growl and bare your teeth. Let's see. And that scares off any scary creatures. Okay, so everyone try that. It's a big growl. That's pretty good. And now you've got to have fun. So you've got to wag your tails. Everyone wag their tails. I don't have a tail. I'm just wagging my bottoms. Is that okay? Yep. Okay, so just wag your bottoms. Okay. And if we want to give a big noise, we've got to make a big, loud wail. Everyone try that. That will definitely scare off anyone. Okay, well, thank you very much for teaching us how to be a fox. We're going to go on the path now, so we'll see you later. Everyone say bye. Bye. So we carry on down the path, and I'm sure we're going to find the Gruffalo, but then we hear... That's a noise that I don't know. Maybe it's the Gruffalo. But it turns out it's not the Gruffalo. It's another forest creature. Let's see who it is. This is Marley Mouse. Everyone say hello to Marley Mouse. And she lives here in the forest. Oh, she's a little bit scared of you guys. Really? Okay, let's learn a little bit about this mouse. She is tiny. She is small. She wants to grow up super tall. No more squeak. She wants a roar. Not being scared like before. So we have to teach this mouse how to be big and brave and strong. A bit like the fox was teaching us. Yeah, Okay, let's try that, everyone. On the count of three, I want you guys to do the biggest, loudest roar ever. Okay, so get ready. One, two, three, go. Whoa! I think you scared Marley Mouse. Marley Mouse, come back out. You try that. Oh, that wasn't very scary, was it? Boys and girls, you're sure again. One, two, three. Whoa, that was pretty good. Marley Mouse thinks she can do it. Go for it.
Roar.
That was much better. Okay, last time, boys and girls, you do your biggest, loudest roar. One, two, three. Whoa, wait, Marley Mouse, you can do it. Go for it.
Roar.
That was pretty good. Give yourselves a clap. Well done. Marley Mouse liked that. Now next, yeah, the boys and girls have got to show you their muscles. So show us all your muscles. Okay, show us your muscles, Marley Mouse. Pretty good muscles. Okay, and lastly, to scare anyone off, we've got to shout boo. So on the count of three, we're all going to shout boo. Ready? One, two, three. That wasn't loud enough, was it, Marley Mouse? No, you've got to be so much louder. Ready? One, two, three. Whoa, that was so good. So Marley Mouse, you have not to be scared. And you can roar and you can show off your muscles and you can say boo. And you can maybe go and ask the fox for help because he was really helpful, wasn't he? Okay, now we're going down the path. You'll never guess who we're trying to find. Yeah, it's the Gruffalo, did you know? Okay, so Marley Mouse knows where we're going and we're not scared, are we, boys and girls? Yeah, I am a bit scared, but they're not scared because they're brave and tough and strong and rawr. Okay, well, listen, we better get on, so let's say bye to Marley Mouse. Bye! So we travel further down the path. Everyone get walking, get marching. Whew. March down the path and then stop. Listen. That's a noise that I don't know. Maybe it's the Gruffalo. But it turns out it's not the Gruffalo. It's another one of our forest friends. Let's see who it is this time. It is Oscar Owl. Everyone say hi to Oscar. Hi. Hi Oscar, how are you? You're very good, but you're guarding the path. Well, we can get past, can't we? What? Oh, please, we need to go to try and find the Gruffalo. He said he'll let us pass if we can solve a riddle. Okay, let's learn about the owl and listen to his riddle. The owl is wise and very smart. Of knowing things, he's made an art. He said he'd let us carry on if we don't get the riddle wrong. Okay, let's hear it. Okay, so this is about a flower or a plant, okay? Okay, I'll tell the boys and girls the riddle and see if they can guess which one it is. Okay, listen up, see if you can solve it. You'll find me in the grass, dressed all yellowy, but then I turn to white, and then I fly away. You'll find me in the grass, dressed all yellowy, but then I turn to white, and then I fly away. So it's a flower that's yellow, and then becomes white, and then flies away. You guys know what it is? Have a little think. Shout out if you know what it is. I think it's a rose. It's not a rose. I think it's a tulip. No. What do you guys think? Okay, I'll ask her. They think it's a dandelion. It is a dandelion. Well done. Give yourselves a clap, boys and girls. You're super smart. Well, can we go on the path now? But be careful. We will be careful. We're not scared, are we? Okay, everyone say bye-bye to the owl. Bye. So we carry on walking the path, and this is a long part of the path. So we've got duck under branches. We've got to climb over fallen branches. Whoop! I think there's a squirrel throwing nuts at our heads. Ow, ow, oh my goodness. And keep walking along, but then we get to the end of the path. We've walked the path from start to end, looked at every corner and every bend. And here's something that I know. There wasn't a single Gruffalo. Maybe he's scared. Or maybe he's asleep. Or maybe he's off walking in the forest deep. Did you hear that? Did you guys hear that noise? That's a noise I think I know. That's the sound of a Gruffalo. Let's get out of here. Run! Did you guys see him? I can't believe I ran away. He didn't look too scary. Now, I hope you had lots of fun on our Gruffalo adventure. Now, I'll see you guys next week as we head under the sea. See you then. Bye.